Quran, those are out of the fold of Islam. If someone believes Aisha is kafira, he is out of the fold of Islam. If someone believes Aisha committed zina, then he is out of the fold of Islam. If someone believes all the Sahaba, they are kuffar, he is out of the fold of Islam. Who Allah testify for them, they are Muslims. So if someone believes, for example, that, the shirk calling other than Allah, calling Ali or Hassan and Hussein with other than Allah, believe that they are in control and charge of to supplicate to, then they are out of the fold of Islam.
My understanding when Shia say Ya Ali, we don't actually mean Ya Ali to Imam Ali. We say like for the love of Ali, something happens.
So did the Mushrikeen of Quraysh. These two not. They say we ask Allah through these idols. So we don't say. I understand. I know.
But like that's I don't think that should be a comparison.
No, it is a comparison. I will tell you why.
For example, if I say to my dad, I'm like, Dad, please, if you love your daughter, please do this for me.
Well, let me tell you something. I will tell you, let me rectify you. You know what the Christians, they do? What they do? So some of them, the Catholic, they say we ask through Saint such and such, or through Jesus, or through this. But they are mushrikeen because of this. They commit shirk because they don't ask. And Allah says in the Quran, وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ ادْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ. Your Lord said to you, call me, supplicate to me. No. You need to know how to call. You don't call indirectly. Allah says, call him directly. Why? Allah doesn't need someone in between. Allah doesn't need someone in the middle.
Oh, but I think it's about the niyyah. So
no, it's not a niyyah. There's two things. The evil deed cannot be rectified with a good intention. It doesn't mean if you have good intention, we are doing evil deed. It doesn't work like this. You have to have good intention and you have to do a good deed, both of them. So good intention, you wanted to ask Allah, correct? So ask Allah directly. Allah said, Ya Allah, why do you need to call Ali?
Because
if you know, then don't do it.
No, because I'm saying as a niyyah. So of course,
it doesn't
course,
matter. Listen, course, I didn't ask about your niyyah.
For example, Laylatul Qadr, your chance of your dua being accepted is more likely in Laylatul Qadr than another day.
Good.
صح. Because in Laylatul Qadr is an important day.
Yes.
But then you say, oh, you just need to call upon Allah.
Yes.
And if it's a good intention, then Allah will accept it.
Yes.
But I'm saying, even if it's like that, right? Well, when we call upon Allah, we call it for the love of Ali. Just like.
Let me tell you something.
How important.
I will add to your information. Yeah? Do you want to call Allah through the love of Ali and Ahlul Bayt? Listen to this. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said in authentic hadith that three people were trapped in a cave, and because of the trap, a giant rock blocked the exit of the cave, and then they said, we have no way to escape from this cave except if we ask Allah through the best deeds that we have done. And then the first one, oh Allah, he said about that he was good to his parents. He said, oh Allah, I used to have sheep and cattle, and I used to bring milk to my parents, and the first one used to drink. And one day, one night I came, I was late, and I was holding the pot of the milk in my hand until the morning. So I was holding it. He said, oh Allah, if I have done that for your sake, help us in our situation. Then Allah Azza wa Jal made the rock to move a bit, and then it was, they have the third of the exit was open. And then the second one, he said he was good to his, someone was working for him and he had fulfilled his right. And the third one was said he didn't commit zina and he was abstained from zina through their righteous deeds. So they ask Allah through their righteous deeds. And I will give you alternatives. Do we love Ahlul Bayt? Yes. Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. We love Ahlul Bayt.
Some people don't.
If someone who is committed, he say he is following the Quran and Sunnah, if he doesn't love Ahlul Bayt, he's not from Sunnah. He's someone else. Call him himself. If someone hates Ahlul Bayt, he is not a Muslim. What this? So that's why if someone hate Ahlul Bayt, hate Ahlul Bayt, meaning all of them, including the wives of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, including the family of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the Sahaba, they have dispute. It happens. Ali radiallahu anhu and the other Sahaba, they have dispute in certain things, but they didn't hate each other. Things happen, but there's normal things between people. Yeah. So here, my point is going back to you. Yeah. So can I make dua through the love of Ahlul Bayt? Yes, but how? So, oh Allah, I ask you that I love Allah and His Messenger and the family of His Messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam. No problem. No, that's not exactly. Listen. No.
When I say
you are Arab, yeah? الكلام. You're people of Iraq, انتم من العراق. You taught people Arabic, you told the world Arabic, and you don't know what's meaning of Ya Ali. We know what means Ya Ali. Ya Ali means asking, literally invoking. You are supplicating. So it is Ya al-Nida wa Ya al-Dua. If it's Nida, Ali did, he's died. You're calling who? If you are making dua for him, you're committing shirk. So that's why instead of doing this, say, oh Allah, I ask you through your names and your attributes, tabarak wa ta'ala. Oh Allah, I ask you that I love Allah and His Messenger and the family of the Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. No problem. No problem. Allahumma inni as'aluka bihubbi laka wa li nabiyika wa li ahli baytihi alayhi salatu wa sallam. No problem. No issues. We have no problem with this. And that's fine. But when you say, oh, ya Ali, then this is the shirk. And that is the shirk where Allah Azza wa Jal has said that, are you calling the dead ones? He said, you are only calling dead ones, dead ones. And Allah is the Hay, alladhi la yamut. Ali is dead, correct? Hassan is dead, correct? Hussein is dead. All of them, they did. They died. Radiyallahu anhum wa ardahum. May Allah resurrect us with them. And may Allah unite us with them in Jannat al-Firdaus with our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yeah? Say ameen.
Ameen.
So we want to be with them. But to be with them, we have to follow their way. And their way, they follow the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Hassan and Hussein, they respect Abu Bakr and Umar. They came to defend Uthman. Can you imagine? They came to defend Uthman. And then Uthman kissed their head. He said, by Allah, you are more dear to me than my own sons. He said to them, because they are the grandsons of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And I don't want this, I don't want you to be harmed for me. So he returned them back. This how much he loved them. Where in fact he needs people to defend him. But yet he returned them back. Why he's doing this? Because he loved them. So my point is, we love Ahlul Bayt. We have no problem with Ahlul Bayt. And don't be deluded by those, I will call them, yani, those mullahs, yeah. Don't be deluded by them who are trying to, you know, to misguide you, to lead you away from Islam. To lead you away from Islam, that's not from Islam. Islam is following Quran, the Quran which has revealed in the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the Sunnah, the authentic Sunnah from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is not just only in his family. It's the Sunnah which came to the Ummah. The whole Sahaba, they learned from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is what we follow, and that's what we believe. So that's why we have to follow them their way. This is the true Islam. So don't be misguided by those mullahs. They wanted to take you away from that. They don't want you. They wanted to take away from this. All these things are more, if nowadays, oh, it's most likely more, it's like Safawi thing, it's not even that tashayyur. It's like Safawi thing, Safawi. Sorry to say it. People of Iraq, they do taqlid of Sistani, correct? Mostly. Does he speak Arabic? Does he speak Arabic? I never heard one recording about it. Don't you think there is something not right there? Don't you see there is something? Yahi, think about it. Don't you think there is something not right there? Listen. No. Don't you think there is something dodgy there? You can't see there is something wrong there? Do you see there is something wrong? Ask you by Allah. Do you see there is something wrong there? Especially when Saddam was removed, when everything that happened, when the Shia came, and then this guy is there to do taqlid on him. Do you see there is something wrong there? My point is, open your mind. So that person, him and the fatawa that he gives, wal-iyadu billah, because he believes in certain things. He caught Kulaini, correct? He caught, for example, Tusi, he caught them. He caught people who believe the Quran is corrupted. He caught them. Kulaini believes the Quran is not intact. By the way, Tusi believes the Quran is not intact. Believe Quran is corrupted. That's how they believe. Huh? Kulaini and Tusi, those are the giant of the tashayyur. Those are the ones who wrote about the Quran, which is most of the tashayyur Rafidi is on them. So that's why, akhi, if you wanted to follow Quran and Sunnah, Quran is very clear. So it's very clear. Quran as it is, the book of Allah, Allah has preserved. Inna nahnu nazzalna al-dhikr wa inna lahu lahafidhun. We have revealed the revelation and we are going to protecting it. So it's protected by Allah, tabaraka wa ta'ala. That's one thing. The other thing as well, The sunnah of the Prophet is preserved, protected by Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. How we learn, how we know how to pray and how to fast, what we do, what we shouldn't do, if the sunnah is not preserved. And Allah has made the scholars of Islam to protect the sunnah. How? By writing the sunnah, to make sure that the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ is there. And there is a sophisticated system to preserve the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. So don't be deluded and say, I do taqlid. No, that's not right. We don't do taqlid. We do taqlid to the Prophet ﷺ, no one else. No one deserves to do taqlid, don't accept the Messenger of Allah ﷺ. That's as simple as that. So that's why, again, and I'm saying this to you, my brothers, you are younger, you are a youngster. You're still yani in the beginning of your life. And that's why, for example, if you see all of these things, doesn't make sense. I will ask you by Allah, does the Shia believe the Mut'ah is allowed? The Shia believes is allowed. No. Listen.
I'm Shia, I told you.
One second. Listen. No, listen. Tell me one Imam says Mut'ah is not allowed.
You're right, but most
Shias do
believe
Mut'ah. No, all of them. Listen. I know. Listen to me. Let me tell you something. Do you know why? Because you are on the fitrah, on the natural disposition. If you study tashayyu, you're going to believe like me. Yeah. Because still fitrah. Fitrah doesn't mean you are young, by the way.
Yeah, I know.
No, fitrah. I'm on fitrah and I'm older than you. It doesn't matter. Yani. My point is, fitrah means you go the natural disposition. That's the meaning of fitrah.
I know.
My point is, because in the tashayyu, it's part of their belief. Yeah. Now the question is, do you think Islam nowadays, Islam will allow mut'ah?
No, 100%. That's a lot.
Good. Why? Why?
It's haram. Is this common sense?
That's my point.
But what
you know what? You know why? I will tell you something. Do you have a sister? Huh?
I'm the only child.
You're the only child. Do you have a sister? Okay. When someone proposed to your sister and marrying her, you will take her hand with your father and give her to her husband, صح? Because you are proud. Alhamdulillah, she's married. They will not be proud. And that's why the mut'ah, you didn't need the permission of the wali.
That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying.
Disgusting. My point is, my brother, wallahi, trust me. If there is some, Allah said, وَلَوْ كَانَ مِنْ عِنْدِي غَيْرِ اللَّهِ لَوَجُدْ فِي اخْتِلَافٍ كَبِيرٍ. If it came from other than Allah, you'll find a lot of dispute about it. So that means this something, the Prophet ﷺ, he died prohibiting mut'ah. Died prohibiting.
Have you ever heard someone give his daughter as like mut'ah? Have you ever heard of this before?
So just no, stay.
I had to go.
Okay, inshallah. Well, let's finish inshallah the brother first before you go, yeah?
Wallahi,
I don't know.
عندي كم إشي لازم أحكي فيها قبل لا نروح على البيت.
يلا no problem.
أنت حكيت إنه أنت في الأردن صح؟
نعم أنا.
أنا كنت عايش بالأردن كمان.
ما شاء الله.
كمان عندي إشي لازم أحكي لك فيها.
نعم تفضل.
أنت حكيت إنه الحسن الحسين وعلي ميتين ما بيسمعوا بس بالقرآن بالعالمين حكى إن الشهداء أحياء وأنتم لا تشعرون.
عند ربهم. يرزقون أحيانا عند ربهم يرزقون. عند ربهم.
طب هو
تعرف إيش عند ربهم؟
يعني
لا 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 أصبر 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 عليه. الله قال ولا تحسب الذي قتلوا في سبيل الله أموات بل أحياء عند ربهم يرزقون. يرزق مش لا تشعرون، عند ربهم يرزقون. عند الله. أنت تدري إيش عند الله؟ ما نعرف. خلاص. لكن بلا شك ولا ريب. الحسن والحسين سيدا شباب أهل الجنة. لا ما عندنا شك في هذا.
أنا أعرف ناس بس سنة بس يسبوا على علي.
هذا مجرمين.
أنا سب
علي. والله العلي العظيم أنا أقول لك حاجة.
أنا أعرف شيء يسبون على عائشة ويسي إيرشن.
علي والله أنا ما سمعت سني يؤمن بالله ورسوله ويتبع السنة. هذا مجرم.
يا شيخ
الذي يسب علي هذا مجرم.
أبو منو؟
أبو ظاهر.
أنا كنت عايش بالأردن خمس أنا وياه عايش.
الأردن قليل إن التدين بعض الناس يعني.
أنا تعرفت عليه بالأردن.
أيوة.
خمس سنين. أنا كنت أروح على الجامع لأن كنت بالعراق أحب الجامع وأروح للجامع.
ما شاء الله.
أوكي. فشنو كنت أحب الجامع كثير.
نعم.
كثير أحب الجامع. فأنا بروح لأنه كان رمضان كنت أروح كل يوم.
أيوة.
لأنه هم سنة أنا بصلي ورا لأنه أنا شيعي بصلي.
لا 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 صلي هيك وعادي وصلي مثل ما هم.
أنا بس هيك. ما
بعرف. يا سيدي.
فشو
انت ما انت مختلف اسمع لا تنتسب
لا بس لما تسمع القصه راح تعرف ليش انا كانوا الاطفال من قد عمري يلحق وراي لانه بيقول اشي ايش
ايه
هذا شيء ثاني
غلط لكن انت انا انصحك
الشيخ بالجامع حكى اللي بيقتل شيعي بيدخل الجنه
اعوذ بالله هذا اجرم مجرم ما يجوز
بسبب هذا الشيخ انا ما رحت على الجامع ولا صليت
لا هذا ما يجوز انا ما هذا ما يجوز هذا حرام لكن انا انصحك في الله لا تنتمي لاي انسان انتمي للاسلام انتمي للاسلام انت مسلم لا تقول والله انا والله شيعي لا تقول هذا انت من الاسلام
اي واحد يسالني انا اقول له مسلم
ولا تقول شيعي
انا اقول مسلم
ولا تقول شيعي لا تقول شيعي انا انصح لا تنصح واتبع القران والسنه السنه هذه سنه الله عز وجل سنه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم هذه ما نتركها اتبعها واقرا وابحث وتعلم وانا مستعد اعلمكم وانتم اخواني لكن ابقوا لا تدعوا مع الله احدا لا تشرك بالله عز وجل لا تدعوا علي ولا تدعوا الحسين ادعوا الله عز وجل ادعوه مخلصين له الدين واعبدوا الله عز وجل حتى ياتيكم اليقين وهو الموت فقط هذا هو اعيش واموت على هذا فهمت واترك عنك هذول الملات وكذا واترك عنك كل هذول القران واضح وسنه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم واضح ما تحتاج احد فهمت انصحك بهذا واترك عنك كل الاشياء الثانيه عرفت الله يا ربي يوفقك يفتح لك أبواب الخير الله ربي يصلحكم يبارك فيكم ويجعلكم هاديين مهديين الله يبارك فيكم جزاكم الله خير كرمكم الله حياك الله.